Let's talk about Power BI parameters. Did you know that there are actually two kinds of Power BI parameters? One are the Power BI query parameters. By changing these, you can change the data that is loaded in your Power BI model. Two are the parameters used in Power BI reports. By changing these parameters, users can change what is shown on the report dynamically. We will cover both and also tell you when it's best to use which approach. You can access the complete playlist at the end of this video. For this video, we will focus on Power BI parameters used in the query editor. Hey, I'm Avi Singh, Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions.
So let's jump into the demo and let me show you the Power BI query parameters. Now, the first place, if you're opening Power BI desktop, you might see this in is if you click the edit queries arrow next to that, and you might see edit parameters right here. Let me mute my cell phone. All right. So, but you would notice that it's grayed out. It's not available because you first need to define this inside the query editor. So we're going to launch that by clicking on this edit queries button, and it launches a new window in the query editor. Now in here for the query editor, you would notice the manage parameters box right there, and it has some options in there. You can manage parameters, edit parameters, or create a new parameter. We're going to just open the manage parameters box over here. So in here, it's nice and blank, and it's got nothing here, which is fine. And this is our AdventureWorks data set. And let me show you one of the reports that we have here. And I apologize to you and to Stephen Few for using a pie chart here, but somehow I ended up with a pie chart. So you can see here is that I have data from all the different countries coming in over here. And what I would like to define is a parameter which lets me select the specific data that comes into my model. So for that, let's go over here. And so sales table is which is collecting sales data. And currently, as you can see, this has data coming in from all different countries. So let's go ahead and define a parameter. So I'm going to go to manage parameters and click the new button. And in here, I have to give it a name. Now, I first tried to name it country, but it wouldn't allow me to name that something which is already exists. So country already exists. So I'm just going to change it slightly and say, let's say selected country. So I did that. I'm going to put a description really quick. So I've specified a description. Now for type, you can select from different data types. For this one, it's going to be text. Now suggested values, you can have any values, list of values, or build the list of values based on a query. So you can query a specific list if it's available somewhere. For now, we're just going to take that from an Excel file, and I'll just copy paste that in. So I'm going to go here and just hit Control V, and that's my list of values. But again, I could have queried it from that Excel file or any other source if I wanted. Now, I'm often when I come over here, I hit OK, but it doesn't let me quite complete this dialog box because the warning it's giving me is that it needs to have a current value, kind of a working value. So I'm just going to select the United States for now so that we can proceed from here. But again, this value is just for me right now so that I can start using it. So let me show you how it's going to actually work from there. So once you have that parameter, the way you would change that would be you would change the edit parameters right here from Power BI Desktop. So you would not need to go to the query editor. Query editor, you only launched it to define the parameter. So now, as you can see, we have data from all countries. Now, what happens if I go in there and I change this to, let's say, Australia? Well, you would find that nothing happens. In fact, even when I selected United States, I was still seeing sales by all countries. So we have one more step to complete, which is to actually take the value of the parameter, be it Australia, United States, whatever is being set in the Power BI desktop window, and use that in my query itself. So for that, sales is the one that's bringing in the sales from all these different countries. So what I'm going to go in here is go to this country field in sales and apply a text filter on it. So I'll say text filter equals And now notice this dialog box that I can specify a value. I can type in United States and it would work. But that's not what we're trying to do. We want this to be dynamic. We want this to change based on the parameter that's specified. So how do we do that? Well, if you notice that this is a drop down, and if you click on that, you can change from instead of text, you can select a parameter. We could have also defined a new parameter right here from this window. But we already have one defined. So I'm going to select parameter. And since we only have one parameter, it just selects that one. If you had multiple parameters, then you would be just select the one that you want. And now we're going to hit OK. And it was current value was Australia, so it's filtered to that. And I'm just going to hit close and apply. And now you can see that it's only showing me sales for the Australia country. So again, now I don't have to go back to the query editor. It's defined, the parameter is defined, it's hooked to my query, it's connected. So I can just come in here, say edit parameters, and just select a different country. Let's go back to States, hit OK. And you have to hit one more button to apply the changes, and it's going to go back to the source and filter that data set based on the parameter that I just specified. So you can see parameters can be used in a lot of flexible ways, in this case to filter the data set, but you could be replacing values, you could be passing values back to a stored procedure. So this all may seem great, and it is, but there's one problem that you should know about.
Now, there's one thing you must understand when using Power BI parameters in the query editor. As of now, these parameters can only be modified using Power BI Desktop. There's no way for users to modify a parameter on PowerBI.com where they're viewing the Power BI reports. Why is this important? As far as Microsoft is concerned, Power BI Desktop is meant to be used only by Power BI model authors. End users are not really supposed to be using this tool. End users consume the reports via PowerBI.com or an on-premise option. And there, the end users currently do not get an opportunity to modify these parameters, these query parameters. If you want to learn more about the author, publish, consume approach that you should be following for Power BI, then watch my complete Power BI tutorial linked here and in the notes below. Anyone who is used to creating SSRS reports should take particular note of this behavior because it is very different from SSRS, where end users can change the parameters when consuming the web report. So if end users are not able to change Power BI query parameters, then are they of any use? And are there any workarounds? Well, yes and yes. Query parameters can be useful. Query parameters can be used along with Power BI templates by model authors who are Power BI Desktop users. They can use it to pass along Power BI Desktop or PBIX models that they can reuse by simply changing the query parameters. So if everybody involved is using Power BI Desktop, query parameters work. We will show you a detailed example in a future video we will be adding to this playlist. I should also point out that the Power BI team is working towards making query parameters accessible via PowerBI.com. If you would like that, let us know in the comments below. What about workarounds? One option is to simply bring in all data inside your model and then let the end users filter that using slicers or other filters. Or you can restrict the data that they see using row-level security. Another workaround is, instead of using the built-in Power BI query parameters, you can have the end users input their parameter value using some other mechanism, such as Power App, SharePoint list, or just an Excel spreadsheet that they update. We plan to cover some of these in future videos. Let us know in the comments below which scenario is of interest to you. We will be adding more videos to this series. You can watch all released videos by clicking on the playlist here or in the description below. Don't forget to join me live on my Talk Power BI show right here on YouTube every Friday, where I will be answering all of your Power BI questions. Just hit subscribe and click that bell so you get the notifications whenever I go live. And if you're new to Power BI, make sure to check out my complete Power BI tutorial. Until next time, power on, my friend.
Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.